Welcome to LifeSci TV. I'm Drew Levinson in New York. With us today, the president and CEO of ARNA Pharmaceuticals, Amit Munshi. Amit, thanks so much for being with us today.
Thank you.
You know, ARNA has gone through quite a transformation in the past 18 months. Tell us a little bit about that.
Sure. So as some of the viewers know, ARNA is about a 20-year-old company and was focused originally on the development of novel compounds against something called G-protein-coupled receptors, or GPCRs. And over many years, they developed a broad basket of potential products. Our focus over the last 18 months has been really to rebuild the company. And what we've really focused on is the pipeline. We focused on rebuilding the management team and some of our core capabilities for drug development. So we've really migrated this company back to really being a drug development company with an absolute crystal focus on the pipeline. We're excited about the pipeline. We're excited about the compounds that we're currently working on. We're excited about the compounds that we currently have sitting on a shelf that we're looking forward to progressing over time. And we think the next few years hold a lot of promise for the company. I'll remind your viewers that our products are not approved. We're subject to a lot of regulatory activity that has to happen over the next several years. But we think each one of our compounds has the opportunity to be a potential first or best-in-class compound for patients, and that's what gets us up in the morning.
You know, you reported positive data mid-year in the Ralinepag program. Tell us more about the program, the data, and where do you go from here?
So Ralinepag is being developed for the treatment of PAH, or pulmonary arterial hypertension. This is a disease that affects the heart and lungs. PAH is a disease of the small distal pulmonary arteries, and these patients develop increased vascular resistance and eventually die of right heart failure. So it's a fatal disease, Drew, and our focus has really been to improve the vasodilation, or the improvement of the blood flow through these small pulmonary arteries. And the drug Ralinepag seeks to really be potentially a best-in-class program for this disease. So we're really excited about where Ralinepag could end up over time. We have a lot more work to do. We're currently at the agencies, the FDA and the European agencies, to begin to get more definition about where the phase 3 program will eventually take us. The phase 2 program seems to suggest very strongly that we have a pretty dramatic effect in patients, even despite the fact that these patients have dual background therapy. In fact, we showed a 20% improvement in pulmonary vascular resistance, or PVR, in these patients, and most of these patients were on dual background therapy. So again, this is unprecedented data. We think that with the right set of experiments and the right program going forward, we should be able to bring forward the therapy that'll change the lives of these patients.
You know, it would seem that the next major milestone you have is in the Etrasimod data in the treatment of UC. Now, how are you thinking about the data, and what are the next steps?
UC is ulcerative colitis. Etrasimod is a program that works on something called S1P. It's known as an S1P modulator. The compound works primarily by reducing T lymphocytes, or immune cells. And by reducing immune cells, it really begins to change the paradigm of a range of autoimmune conditions. The first data readout is in ulcerative colitis. We expect that data in the first part of 2018, and it'll be the first time we've been able to show data in patients with this compound. Previously, we've shown in healthy volunteers that we can reduce these immune cells dramatically as fast as 3 days. So the drug has a very fast onset of action. It has a very fast offset of action, meaning you can recover these immune cells very quickly. What's exciting about etrasimod is etrasimod has improved pharmacology and improved pharmacokinetics, and has the potential to be a best-in-class agent. So we're really excited about seeing this data, and we're really excited about what the potential future holds for the compound.
So as I understand it, then, etrasimod may have utility in many autoimmune conditions?
That's right, Drew. So the way we think about this, and if I could just take a step back for a moment, many autoimmune conditions are what are called T lymphocyte driven. So T lymphocytes are a type of immune cell. These conditions, and we think there's several hundred of these indications, and for etrasimod, we think there's somewhere between 80 and 100, which we think are very viable indications. So blocking S1P or modulating S1P with etrasimod really drives down T lymphocytes, and driving down these immune cells should have a beneficial effect in these autoimmune conditions. And as we mentioned, we've already begun work in ulcerative colitis. We expect that data in the first part of next year. We also have multiple other indications up and running, one of them being pyoderma gangrenosum, which is a fairly rare skin disorder. And following from there, we've initiated a trial in PBC, or primary biliary cholangitis. And again, that study's up and running. We're looking forward to seeing data. And throughout 2018, we hope to better define the etrasimod strategy as we look across a broad range of these T T-cell mediated autoimmune condition. So look forward to sharing that with you at some future point in time.
Now, as you think about the business aspect of this, what should investors be looking for in the next few quarters?
We're really excited about the next few quarters. We've got, of course, the readout from the agencies on Ralinepag in terms of where we'll take the program. We're looking forward to having that conversation with investors. Additionally, we'll have data readouts on APD371, which is our novel compound for pain associated with Crohn's disease. We have the etrasimod data we just discussed, talking about a readout in Q1 for ulcerative colitis. And so a very busy couple of quarters coming up for us as a company.
I was going to say, so much going on. When you look at this, what excites you the most?
You know, every compound that we have in our portfolio, we believe has a chance to be a first or best in class compound, meaning that we have the opportunity to make a disproportionate impact on the lives of patients. You know, every time we look at compounds in our pipeline, and we have additional compounds that we haven't publicly discussed yet, but every time we look at these compounds, we begin to improve our focus as a company going forward. We're really excited in 2018, not only in terms of getting this data out there, but being able to improve the focus of the company going forward. So 2018 really has sort of two components for us. Primarily, it's the data readouts, but just as important maybe is a further refining of our strategy as a company going forward. It's very rare to see a company in our size category with as many potential shots on goal as we do. So for investors, it's going to be very important for us to begin to focus, to begin to reshape the company as we go forward for the next 18 months.
2018 is going to be a monumental year for you.
Yeah, we're very excited about it and look forward to continuing the conversation as we get through 2018.
We do too.
Great.
Amit Munshi, President and CEO of ARNA Pharmaceuticals. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you, Drew. Appreciate it.